Hello and welcome to Unit 1.1 of our course, The Fascination of Crystals and Symmetry. In this very first unit, we will try to get an idea what is actually meant by crystals, by structures. We want to see how large or small crystalline objects can be. This means which scales do we consider if we want to explore crystals and structures. For this, let's have a look onto the following slide. It is based on a famous short film from the year 1977, and it is called Powers of Ten. This short film shows nicely how large or how small different objects of scientific investigations are. We do not want to go through all of these now, but let's have a look on a few of them. Here at the top left corner, it starts with the largest galactic object, the Milky Way, with a diameter of 100,000 light years. Interestingly, also the universe has a structure, in fact a very heterogeneous one. There are areas which are very condensed, there are for instance these super globular clusters, and on the other side there are huge areas which are almost empty. Okay, but this is clearly the domain of astrophysics, so let's switch back to the overview, and then we go down to the planet Earth and come to this house, approximately 10 meters in size. The question is, are there crystals which are as large as houses? This is indeed the case. Look at this spectacular picture here. You see a researcher in a crystal cave exploring one of these huge crystal columns which are made of selenide. This crystal cave is located in Mexico at the mine of Naica, and it is a side cave of this mine which was only discovered very recently by accident, and now it has the beautiful name Cueva de los Cristales. Being a researcher there is actually quite uncomfortable because of the drastic conditions, with temperatures up to 50 degrees Celsius and a relative humidity of almost 100%. This is also the reason why the expedition team members have to wear special cooling suits. The exploration of this cave is really a story in itself, and you can find an interesting article about it in the magazine National Geographic as additional material to this unit. Apparently, the conditions in this cave must have been relatively constant over a very long period of time, allowing this extreme large crystals to grow. The age of the largest crystals, which are approximately 14 meters long, is estimated as 100,000 to 1 million years. Let's switch back to the overview, and we go further down on this scale, and we come to a region between a football and a ladybird. This is the typical size of exhibition objects that you can find in science museums. Here we see a greenish fluorite crystal, normally colorless and transparent, here greenish due to certain impurities. And this fluorite crystal is framed by agglomerations of smaller calcite crystals, which is calcium carbonate. This object is 5 times 5 centimeters and also from the mine of Naica. Let's switch back again and go further down on the scale. Then we reach a dimension of the thickness of a sheet of paper, a tenth of a millimeter. And this is the typical size of single crystals in research. Here you can see a nice blue sparkling crystal of a so-called metal organic framework. It is placed here on such a nylon loop because it is being prepared for an X-ray experiment in order to solve the structure of this specimen. We will come back to this class of materials, to metal organic frameworks, in one of our following units in the chapter Topology and Networks. Once again, back to the overview. In order to describe the outer shape of crystals, the morphology, we are in this region here. But, of course, crystals do have also an inner structure. And in order to explore this inner structure, we have to go down further on this scale, several orders of magnitude, till we reach the dimensions of molecules or atoms. Atoms or molecules are the constituents of our crystal, and these are arranged in a certain manner that we will explore very soon in this course. Of course, we could go still further down on this scale and would reach subatomic sizes and structures. Atoms also have a substructure, as do the constituents of atomic nuclei, the protons and neutrons. But this is clearly the area of high energy physics, which we will not address in our course. To summarize this unit, if we look at the inner structure of crystals, then we are in the region between 10 to the power of minus 10 meters, the chemist says also 1 angstrom, and a few nanometers. And if we want to describe the outer dimensions of crystals, we are in this region here between a sheet of paper and a football, with the exception of the giant crystals in the mine of Naica.